Hey, what is going on, you guys? It is Mr. No Sleep here from Old School RuneScape, and welcome to a brand new loot video for you all today. Today I bring you loot from 10 hours of killing water fiends. This time we are on the Iron Man account. The gear for this video is a leaf-bladed battle axe, full carols, Guthan's helmet, as well as a dragon defender, a fury with the barrow's gloves and dragon boots, along with a fire cape. The inventory is going to be a set of full Guthan's, just in case I need to use it in order to get some HP back. I also brought one super set as well as one prayer potion every inventory, and of course the herb sack and rune pouch, which was filled with high alks. The gaming necklace is because I was banking at Barbarian Assault, so it's also a pretty quick run to the waterfall, which is where I was killing these water fiends at. And of course the rest of my inventory was at the moment just a lot of pizzas, because it did act as the best food to bring. And then once I ran out of those, I just simply replaced it with sharks, carambuans, or anglerfish. Here we are killing the water fiends. As you can see, the leaf-bladed battle axe is set to crush, because they are weak to crush attacks or just smashing weapons in general. If I had a bludgeon on this account, I would definitely be bringing that here instead, but the leaf-bladed battle axe is actually my best-in-slot crush weapon. Other than this, I really wouldn't recommend any other weapon here. I personally have tried out a whip as well as range and magic, and they just have such high defense that I would really just go with your best-in-slot crush weapon in order to kill these water fiends. Luckily, the Guthan spear does have a crush setting, so anytime I needed to use that, I would certainly want to be praying range, because if I wasn't, then I'd just be continuously taking damage from these water fiends, and I would use that to get my HP back up if I felt necessary. But usually by the time all of my inventory of food was gone, I would have a whole nother inventory of fresh drops, and then I would just simply bank and come back. I think I was banking maybe twice an hour, sometimes one, depending on RNG and if I was getting any shark drops, which occasionally you will get two unnoted shark drops, and that combined with the lucky heals from the set of Guthans can definitely extend your trip. Now, one thing I want to point out is that you can kill these water fiends in the Isleworth dungeon, but I have not completed Song of the Elves on my Iron Man yet, so that's the only reason why I was killing them in the waterfall. Other than that, you can also kill them in the Kraken Cove, but you have to be on Slayer task to kill them in that area. So this was my best bet. The only thing that I would do different is, instead of using the gaming necklace to bank at Barbarian Assault, I would have probably just used the minigame teleport after a while, because these do become unaggro to you, I think after like 10 or 15 minutes, and then I would go to Clan Wars to restore all of my HP and prayer, and then I would use my fishing skill cape to teleport to Otto's Grotto, and that would be right next to the waterfall. But honestly, this would have just saved me a few minutes every hour, so it's really not that big of a deal. Now, as it goes for killing these water fiends, it's really just a known Slayer task that you can get assigned from Duradel or Konar. They're the only two masters that can actually assign these, and it is considered a rare assignment. Now, to unlock them as a task, you do have to have 75 combat, and you have to be progressed in the barbarian training just to the access of the ancient cavern part, and that's really it. Other than this, you can just simply find other players killing them in order to complete an elite clue step. I really would never see people casually killing water fiends as a money-making method or on an Iron Man account to build up supplies, but you guys know I kill almost everything in the game, so luckily for you, I'm gonna be stacking up these water fiend kills off task, and we're gonna see how much money I can make in 10 hours and see all the drops that I will receive. Now, the rarest drop that you can get, even if you're off task while killing water fiends, is a mist battle staff that is 1 in 3,000. What you'll always receive per kill is one water rune and one fiendish ash. I didn't really mind with the ashes. I don't have a sanctifier or anything like that, so I didn't use the ashes to my advantage. And one thing I also didn't bring, even though they do have coin drops, is a ring of wealth to automatically pick them up. I figured I needed all the strength bonus necessary, so I was just bringing my Berserker Ring imbued, and I was just picking up the 2.5k coin drops as they were coming to me. They do drop a lot of gems, but luckily they're noted, so you don't have to bring a gem bag. You will occasionally get an unnoted gem, but it's just not worth it to bring the gem bag based off of that. As it goes for the herb sack, you can expect upwards of Harlander to Dwarfweed, like 8 herbs worth picking up, but it's really just 1 in 160 up to like 1 in 600 for those herbs, so you're not going to be using the sack that much, but it's still worth it to bring over time if you're going to spend, you know, multiple hours here or kill thousands of these things. As it goes for the other drops, you can get a lot of mithril ore noted, as well as raw lobster and raw shark, which is really nice because they do add up, and that's some good cooking XP and smithing XP that I can get eventually. And this is actually a nice monster to kill if you want to get some unique runes on your account. For example, they drop 25 to 75 mist runes, 75 to 100 mud runes, and 40 to 60 steam runes. And if you're not all about those types of runes, they do drop drop 150 waters, so you can expect to get a lot of those. That's like 1 in 20. And then you're looking at 23 death runes and 17 blood runes, which is about 1 in 25 to 1 in 42. The high alcs are definitely necessary because you're not only going to be getting a normal water staff as a drop, but you're also going to get the water battle staff, the mystic water staff, a rune med helm, a couple adamant items, as well as blue dehyde vamp braces, and the rune med and rune full helm drops. So yeah, that's why all the coin drops, as well as everything that I was high alking, is really making an impact on that coin stack in the inventory, and that'll just be growing all video long. And something that I will say for the end is all of the hard clue scrolls, since they are 1 in 128 here, and I will be trying to complete every single one of them as soon as I get them. So we should have some hard clue caskets for the end. And other than that, I'm just really waiting on this Miss Battle Staff drop. If I can somehow pull that off, then I'm pretty much done at Water Fiends forever. But yeah, I mean, these aren't the most popular monster in old school RuneScape. They were definitely known in RuneScape 3 for the Crimson Charm drops, I believe is what they were killed for. But in this game, they did buff the drop table. I think this was around 2016 to include more valuable drops. But yeah, I mean, you don't see bots killing these things. You don't really see normal players camping these things for certain resources or supplies. It's really just a common slayer task, or uncommon, I should say. And I would say the only benefit of killing them in the Isleworth dungeon is that you can receive crystal shards from them, which is like a 1 in 24 drop, and they will add up to a decent amount. So that's the one thing I was missing out on, because I couldn't kill them in that location. But for the most part, I was alone here. I think I only ran into one guy at the very end who was on task, and there was plenty of water fiends for the two of us. So, I mean, you know, this is a pretty empty area in general. And they are considered to be demonic, so you can use Demon Bane weapons on these water fiends, but I just don't have any accessible, so I didn't really go out of my way to do that. One thing I was thinking about as I'm sipping this black coffee, voice-overing today's video for you guys, is that, you know, this is a water fiend, and there's also other fiends in the game, such as Pyre Fiend, common slayer task for lower levels, and also Ice Fiends, also another common slayer task. Well, those drop tables on those monsters are terrible, and yet the water fiend is such high combat compared to those other fiends in the game, and their drop tables, I'd say average. You know, I'm making about, we'd say roughly 400k an hour here, which really isn't too much of a spoiler, because I'll be mainly showcasing the drops from this one. So yeah, it's just fascinating to me that they chose the water fiend to buff to an extreme extent, and then also make the drop table a little average. I kind of wish that pyre fiends were more of a med level monster, somewhat like the water fiend, and that way you could have better drop tables all around. But these are just coffee thoughts, so let me know what you think. Well, there is our missed battle staff, not even coming close to killing 3,000 of them, but Water Fiends has been completed. Not sure if, oh yeah, that was a new collection log slot. I just think I was late to record it. So that is awesome. It actually looks really cool as a staff. I'm not sure if I'm ever going to use it one day, but you guys know I'm going to definitely put that in the bank for, you know, some point in the future. Maybe I'll get some use from it. But other than that, all these other drops are stacking up. I think one of the most beneficial things from this video will be all of the water orbs that I'm going to be crafting and then high alking. I think I got well over 400 of those. So that's a lot of crafting XP, as well as a lot of money once I high alk them. So that'll be very nice. And all of the GP that I make from this video, I'll be dumping into my kingdom. Just collected my resources after about 3 weeks, and I'm down to 10k GP. So all that GP from this video will be going directly in there for some more herbs and planks. And there's another clue casket that we will add to the collection. We now have 4 that I am able to open at the end here. I was unable to complete quite a few of these hard clues just due to some item stash units that I have not built yet. Either way, it did pain me to train strength on this account. You guys know I'm going for 200 mil defense long term, but I almost hit 21 mil strength during this video. Unfortunately, when you have to use crush, you're always going to be getting strength XP, so there's really nothing I can do about that. But that's all right. It was worth it to get much faster kills here. Overall, it was a really enjoyable experience. I did this while doing the 10 hours of organized crime video, which for those who watched it, thank you very much for that. And here we are yet again wrapping up another 10 hour loot video. Loot from 10 hours of Water Fiends has been completed. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and price check the 1125 Water Fiends that I did end up killing. Overall loot from 10 hours does come out to be rounded down 3.3 million GP. Not quite 400k an hour, but once we add the clues in there, we might get a little closer to that. 1.3 million GP, which is going to help for the kingdom. A lot of runes, as well as Snapegrass, which is really nice for my prayer potions. Over 500 water orbs, which will be nice for crafting. And of course, the famous Mist Battle Staff. All right, now it's time for the hard clue scrolls. 4 caskets to open. Looks like we're starting with 97k, following that, a nice 100 154k, and then we have a pretty close to 200k there, nice 14 teleports. And the last clue, we get a shiny piece of rune, this time being the plate legs, another collection log slot obtained, and another 500k from the clue scrolls. Now it's time to show the rune light loot tab, as always, just to confirm that we did actually do this. And another thing to mention, all those sapphire bolts are going to come in handy for the phantom muspa in the future, so yeah, I didn't even think about that. Look at all those alkables, as well as all that XP that I can get in quite a few different skills. So yeah, really happy with the results from this one. Thank you all for watching the video today, I appreciate it. And a big thank you to the YouTube channel members, with a special shout out to Swan Positive and Matthew Stivers. And if you guys need a VPN, feel free to check out the description below. You can save money and get your first 3 months free with ExpressVPN. So big shout out to them as well. All right, take care, guys. I'll see you tomorrow with Barrows. Until then, Mr. No Sleep out.